Deputy Inspector General of Police, Major General Lokech, ending that report and that briefing there of security forces. Now, there was a bit of anxiety in Mbarara City earlier today as a senior medical doctor at the Baylor College of Medicine was being evacuated by UPDF chopper to Kampala for specialized treatment of COVID-19. The anxiety was within the city as the doctor was being put on the chopper. Meanwhile, the Mbarara District COVID Task Force is considering setting up a tent to accommodate what officials say are over 300 patients grappling with COVID-19. Let's have the details in the following report.
Hovering over Mbarara City as it traces proper coordinates of Mbarara University playground where it landed, this army helicopter stirred panic among Mbarara City dwellers. No sooner had it landed than residents surrounded it while taking pictures. Shortly, two ambulances emerged from Mbarara Referral Hospital. Medics in overall suits would then emerge carrying a patient on a stretcher who was later established to be a doctor from Baylor, Uganda, a non-governmental health organization in Uganda. Though hospital authorities were elusive, we learned that the doctor has spent a couple of days battling COVID-19 as some remain in critical conditions.
We've been in a COVID meeting since morning. We have just finished. So I've not yet got whether he was on oxygen or not, but of course, when you see him evacuated with an helicopter, that one means he has been critically sick. He should have been on oxygen.
The second wave, which began on the 20th of May, 2021, which is exactly 2 weeks, we've registered 101 COVID-19 positive cases. 83 are being treated from home, and 17 are inside here being treated. Since then, we've lost 4. The one has just passed on, unfortunately, and all those 17 are on oxygen.
In less than 2 weeks, Mbarara Referral Hospital has lost 4 patients of COVID-19.
When COVID comes, we are isolating all those positives and we treat them in certain areas where they don't mix with others. So the rest of the patients you can even see in the wards, they are full. So anyone who presents with those signs, we remove him and put him in isolation. So it will not affect other services, I said, but maybe if the numbers overwhelm the hospital, but we will not reach that situation.
Important to note, the first outbreak of COVID-19 saw this facility admit over 700 patients with 49 deaths. Meanwhile, border authorities in Mbarara City have conducted an operation against their fellows who don't observe protocols laid down to prevent the spread of the virus. Report by Halson Kagure for the news in Mbarara.